Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Sir, my apologies. There was a technological glitch on the last occasion. Believe me, I have been present all day, sir. Honorable Speaker, sir, I thank the Honorable Member for the question. But in order to address the urgent repatriation needs of Fijians, the Ministry of Commerce, Trade, Tourism and Transport has been working tirelessly with our health officials and people on the ground to facilitate the safe movement within Fiji. The domestic repatriation is a whole of government approach. And whilst the registration is actually done by the MCTTT, the issuance of passes are done by the divisional medical officers in consultation with the divisional commissioners. Mr. Speaker, sir, the task has actually been nothing short of challenging. And then, for some, after months of being away from their families, it's not been easy telling people that they actually have to wait longer and that they need to quarantine. These are Fijians who have been stranded and they've been away from home, away from their loved ones. And there are those who live in one place and have their farms and their sources of livelihood in another, and desperately wanting to return, sir. And then there are those who actually need urgent medical attention. Mr. Speaker, sir, following the announcement of the Honorable Prime Minister on the 29th of May, 2021, the Ministry began registering these Fijians. And we have registered more than 20,000 Fijians for domestic repatriation to date. Of this, 57% are from the Central Division and 5% from the Eastern and 13% from the Northern and 25% from the West. The repatriation, Honorable Speaker, sir, is only for those Fijians who are permanently relocating and not for for short-term visits. And briefly, sir, if I could just elaborate on how this domestic repatriation is actually being facilitated, and it's good for all the members of this House so that we can actually relay the message for those that still are not in the know. First, we register them via the 163 option, 163 number, and option two is the phone line or email, which is domesticrepatriation@gmail.com. Once they're registered, the number provided to them is used as a reference when liaising with the Commissioner's Office or the Provincial Administrator or the District Officers within the division that they're in. And that is their current location. Alternatively, sir, registered individuals can further dial 163, which is option three, on the step-by-step process for the issuance of passes. Now, prior to the issuance of these passes, sir, the divisional commissioners with the divisional medical officers will conduct verification to confirm that the persons or person registered are permanently relocating and not just visiting. And passes are actually issued by the Ministry of Health and Medical Services upon the satisfaction of the adherence to health protocols and to quarantine arrangements. So as you can see, Honorable Speaker, sir, it is not haphazard, and I apologize for the lengthy answer to this, sir, but as of today, it's important that everybody knows what's going on, especially the members of the opposition, because it's not an easy task. We've managed to reunite 5,647 Fijians, or 28.3% of those that are registered with their families, sir. The government is actually working, contrary to what the opposition may think, contrary specifically to what Biman Prasad, Honorable Biman Prasad may think, the government is actually working in a structured and systematic manner and applying stringent measures to stop the virus from spreading, sir. Not every single application is approved. What we do is assess how genuine the application is in terms of the request, and because we need to look at the bigger picture, sir, we need to take care of all Fijians. And one way of doing this is ensuring that more and more Fijians are actually vaccinated against COVID-19. And until more Fijians are vaccinated, the requirements, Honorable Speaker, sir, for cross-border movement and repatriation will remain controlled, sir. And that is that Fijians who want to travel to the North and Maritime Islands are required to have a negative swab result and quarantine for 14 days before each departure and upon arrival at their destination. So all those traveling will need to be fully vaccinated. And this is so we can actually maintain the green zone status of the North and the Maritime Islands. And I think every single citizen will appreciate the fact that we're trying to keep the North green, sir, still green, and our Maritime Islands need special attention and protection, sir. Mr. Speaker, sir, by now we know how different and how much more transmissible the Delta variant is. And the other side of the House may argue that mandating vaccination is not right. But, sir, we must remember this, that while the risk of severe illness or death is significantly reduced through the vaccination, the risk of transmission and infection also significantly reduces. And this is backed by science and CDC reports. Some of the members of the House may also think that being vaccinated gives people the freedom to go anywhere and not to follow the protocol. So not so. You must continue to adhere and follow all the protocols, sir. Being vaccinated, Honourable Speaker, sir, is just one of the requirements. Vaccination plus the social distancing, plus the mask, and following the set protocols is actually important, in addition to the 14-day quarantine when moving from red to green zone, will reduce the risk of virus spreading significantly from red to green zone, sir. Mr. Speaker, sir, we are doing all of this because there are Fijians that are critically in need to return to their homes or to their loved ones or to their farms and their businesses. And the national vaccination target is also to ensure that our green zones, the population on Vanua Levu and the Maritime Islands, are protected before travel can resume as normal. And that is of the utmost of importance to us at the moment, sir. Today, we have about 36.8% of the eligible population fully vaccinated, and 91.3% have received their first dose, sir. And we're very proud that Fijians are taking on the vaccination, not only to save their lives, but also the lives of their loved ones. And that, sir, is not a statement that's made lightly. We must protect ourselves and our loved ones and our neighbors. Mr. Speaker, sir, the numbers speak for themselves in Fiji. Not a single fully vaccinated person has actually passed away of COVID-19. According to the CDC in the United States, of the 166 million fully vaccinated persons, only 0.001% have actually died from COVID-19, or 0.005% have actually been hospitalized. Australia's chief medical officer stated that death rates in the third wave of the pandemic are lower due to the vaccination. So you can see how important it is for us to all get vaccinated, sir. We have to understand that these are life-saving policies. Contrary to what the Honorable Biman Prasad may think, that we're doing these haphazard activities and nobody knows what's going on. Completely wrong and utterly, sir, it could be considered as utter nonsense when he actually says things like we're being irresponsible. Decisions such as no jab, no job are critical to make your workplace and travel safe. We have to remember, Mr. Speaker, sir, vessels are workplaces. Our ports are workplaces. Our buses are workplaces. So we don't only owe it to ourselves, but others in their places of work. We want to ensure that when you return home, your family is safe. Similarly, vaccination is very important if we will leave the containment zone, sir, to go to a safe zone. We want that zone to remain safe. There are many, many parts to the whole equation, sir. We will continue putting in all the necessary efforts to safely repatriate our Fijians, and our target will remain to move all genuine repats as safely as possible, sir. I thank you, and I hope that answers the question, Honourable Speaker, sir.
I thank the Honourable Minister.